In module 1, we are studying it vector differentiation. So important terminologies what we come across in vector differentiation, I am going to explain it here. First terminology is scalar function. A scalar function, always we denote it with notation phi in the form of x square y plus 3x, any some function in terms of x, y, z. Observe that scalar function is a function of x, y and z variable. Next is vector function. A vector function, a vector or f vector, any form you can write it down. X square y into I cap plus 3xy j cap plus 2z k cap. Observe the difference between scalar function and vector function. Scalar is a magnitude which don't have direction. So along with I, x axis, y axis, j, z axis, it is not defining it. Yes or no? Vector means it has both magnitude and direction. So I cap represent along with x axis, j cap represent along with y axis, k cap represent along with z axis. So I, j, k term will not be there in scalar function. That is the first observation. Next is, we are using it a vector differential operator. Differential operator is different. Vector differential operator is different. What is vector differential operator? It is nothing but partial derivative with respect to x into I cap, partial derivative with respect to y into j cap, plus partial derivative with respect to z into k cap. We denote it differential operator with del. We come across with three types of functions: gradient, divergent and curl. It is nothing but a multiplication of vector differential operator with scalar function. Vector differential operator with vector function. Okay, first one, if vector differential operator is multiplied with scalar function, del into phi. So this into this. So what we are going to get? Partially differentiate phi with respect to x into I cap. Then partially differentiate phi with respect to y into j cap. This phi is multiplied to del. So this phi term should be multiplied to each term in the right hand side of the differential operator. Plus dou phi with respect to z into k. It means partial derivative of the phi function with respect to z. So this is nothing but defined as gradient. Gradient of a scalar function which results into a vector function. So whenever you are solving a gradient of any scalar function, observe that answer should be in vector form. Next, when I apply multiplication of vector differential operator on vector function, there are two types of vector multiplication. One is dot product, another one is cross product. So dot product of the vector function, we define it as divergent. Cross product of a vector function with vector differential operator, we define it as curl. What is the formula for divergent of a vector function? Write the differential operator dot, write the a vector, generally some vector, a vector, a1 I cap plus a2 j cap plus a3 k cap. When we do dot product, what it will be left out? We know I dot I is 1, j dot j is 1, k dot k is 1. So you get a quantity for that. Other than that, I dot j is 0, I dot k is 0, j dot I is 0, j dot k is 0. Similarly, k dot I is 0 and k dot j is 0. So we get a quantity only when we are doing it a dot product with a similar vector identities. So I dot I, so dou a1 by dou x, dou a2 by dou y plus dou a3 by dou z. So this is a formula for divergence of a vector function. Now curl of a vector function is nothing but cross product. how we define a cross product? It is nothing but determinant of first row will be the unit vectors I, j, k. Second row will be always when you do the cross product, second row will be always the coefficient of unit vectors I, j, k. What is the coefficient of I, j, k of vector differential operator? It is nothing but observe the del is dou by dou x is the coefficient of I cap. Dou by dou y is a coefficient of j cap. Dou by dou z is a coefficient of k cap. And A vector means what it is? A1, A2, A3 are the coefficient of I, j, k respectively. Solve this determinant, you are going to get a curl. This is the basic terminology is what we are studying it. Next, one more type problem we do is directional derivative. Directional derivative is defined as del phi dot n cap, where n cap is unit normal vector defined as d vector divided by magnitude of d vector. Let me solve one problem related to that. Find the directional derivative of a function f at some particular point along with the direction of this vector. So this is nothing but d vector. To find out n cap, we are using it. And instead of phi function, here f function is given, and which is a scalar quantity. Observe that. So del f we need to find out. What is the formula for a del f? Dou f by dou x into I cap, dou f by dou y into j cap, plus dou f by dou z into k cap. What I have defined it here in terms of phi. Here only in terms of f. So what is the meaning? F function partially differentiate with respect to x, keeping y and z constant. So this term completely constant, so derivative becomes 0. Here y square constant, derivative of x is 1, so y square into I cap, plus f with respect to y, differentiate with only y variable, derivative of y square is 2y into x, so 2xy, then derivative of y is 1 multiplied with z cube into j cap. Then with respect to z, here there is no z term, so 0. Here derivative of z cube is 3z square into y. Next, del f answer, you find out with particular point they have given 2, minus 1, 1. Substitute x as 2, y as minus 1, z as 1 in this answer. You get a vector as I cap minus 3j cap minus 3k cap. And n cap will be obtained for directional derivative along with given direction. What is a along with given direction vector? I cap plus 2j cap plus 2k cap divided by magnitude of d vector. How we calculate magnitude? Square root of square of the coefficient of I, that is 1 square, plus square of the coefficient of j, 2 square, plus square of the coefficient of k, that is 2 square. So 4 plus 4, 8 plus 1, 9. Square root of 9 is nothing but 3. Next, find out directional derivative. Substitute in the formula del f dot n cap. So del f answer you have to write, and n cap you have to write. Do the dot product. I dot I is 1. So 1 into 1 by 3. This divided by 3 is common denominator for all I, j, k. Minus 3 into 2 by 3. Minus 3 into 2 by 3. When you simplify, you get minus 11 by 3. So that is the directional derivative for the given function f.